Hey, welcome back to the Artie Lang Show. It's getting crazy in here. We're doing batting stances from the 70s, 80s, 90s. The great Julia McCullough, real funny comedian, was just doing Will Clark's batting stance.
Yeah.
That was very good. I never saw someone do a Will Clark before.
That's as far as I can go, is stand there.
Like, no, but he was stiff. He was a real stiff.
He was, like, yeah.
With a big chaw in his mouth. And then, Brent, you were doing, I guessed Brian Downing. I'm almost positive that's who that was. Real open stance, and then he would come in the last second.
I accidentally did Brian Downing. I thought I was doing Jerome Walton, the leadoff hitter for the Cubs.
Well,
late 80s,
no, but you might have been. I'm not as familiar with Jerome Walton's work.
Well, I was trying to celebrate Dan's Chicago days, but hey, Will Clark, sweetest swing in the history of baseball.
Well, that's what I mean, he's up there, but I don't think so. I mean, you could
Ted
have
Williams.
You could have that opinion,
but it was sweet.
God, no. I mean, the sweetest swing in the history of baseball is probably a lefty. I mean, they all got nice cuts, but
I mean, don't real baseball people say it's Griffey?
Ken Griffey Jr. Yeah,
he's out there.
Don Mattingly had an unbelievable swing.
Yeah.
Ted Williams, of course, but Darryl Strawberry when he swung.
Oh man.
Perfectly, but no. You know what? Ken Griffey Jr. is tough to beat. Yeah. That's a pretty, pretty swing.
Why do lefties throwing, shooting, swinging a bat? It's always prettier.
I don't know.
Than righties. I always wished I was a lefty.
I bat lefty and throw righty.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Did you play ball?
I did, yeah. I was a varsity shortstop. Since you brought it up, I guess we'll talk about
baseball
it.
Baseball in high school?
Yeah.
Nice. Well,
I mean, did you go and past that?
No, because once you play varsity high school, it gets like, it's not about having fun at all anymore. It's like results.
Yeah, when I played, I was an all-county third baseman.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I wasn't like that.
I played all-county third. I hit 405 my senior year. And I led the team in homers, and I made all county.
You should get back out there.
Well, listen, I put on a couple.
The fundamentals never go away.
Not
the fundamentals
lie to you.
Never
I could
go
probably,
away.
I could probably just stand at third, and balls will just hit and deflect out. I was talking about literally 100 pounds lighter. I was.
How
literally,
were you on defense?
Literally,
that's a great. Tough position to play.
I couldn't run, but I was an amazing fielder, and I had a decent arm. But I could hit the ball. singles and doubles.
What's the article at your house that they picked you out, some Florida league or something? What was that?
They picked me out. I won a thing where I went down to Florida. But I made the all-star team in Little League when I was 12. And they picked out an all-star team to go down to Florida, to Fort Lauderdale, the Yankees training camp. Mm. And I went down there. Bobby Mercer ran it. And when I was down there, they watched me field, and Bobby Mercer got the Miami Herald to do a whole article on me about how good I was in the field. It was crazy.
Wow.
I mean, I was an athlete. I mean, to tell you how downhill I've gone.
He was a cat.
No, he was not a cat. I was more. I could field the ball. They called me Hands. That was my nickname. Nowadays after Sandusky, the innocence is over and Hands means something quite different. No, even I got Mike Buschetti too. I've seen pictures of Mike. Mike, I saw a picture of Mike when he was 21 years old. You weighed like, you look like human.
I was like about 155 pounds.
155?
Yeah.
No kidding.
I worked out, went to karate for years. It was awesome.
Karate. Show us some karate moves.
No, it's been a long time, but I had.
Well, show us a couple of karate moves.
It's not as good as it used to be. I mean, you know.
So, that
was when it was 70s karate. That was like real karate.
Elvis karate.
Yeah.
Some people getting that like.
Well,
that.
Did you have a cape?
No, this is when guys were like in their. No, Julian's right, because this is when guys were like in their faces broken open by their teachers, actually.
That wasn't karate, Mike. I don't know what you were going to.
No. These guys were intense.
Did you ever hear Tell's joke where he goes, you know, when you're a kid, you think your father's Superman. You get older and you realize he's just a drunk who likes to wear a cape. Yeah. No, but so you're already refusing to do bits on the show, Mike? You're that high up on your horse?
Oh, it's been a long time.
But do one karate move for us.
Okay, so they had katas. I don't know if you guys know what that was. Like a fighting.
I don't need that. What are you giving us a definition? You're not even getting up.
I'll get up. Hold on.
Nice.
I watch. You'll have a heart attack, and I'll be sued.
Yeah.
Don't talk.
Grabbing somebody.
Yeah.
Choking it. punch him to the face quick and then grab him and boom. And then,
you know, he still got it. Yeah.
The form is there, but yeah. What you did in the time it took you to do that, I think like
yeah, probably the best thing to do is step on somebody's toe and you punch him in the face.
As long as the guy is already choking, you got that guy.
In the time it took you to do that, four members of the Latin Kings could have stole your car, sold it for parts.
They could have got their lives together and gone back to school in the time.
Julian's right. In the time it took you to do that, four members of the Latin Kings could have stolen your money, used the money for good, turned their lives around, and actually had a TV movie made about their lives.
No, but yeah. Art, I also had studied judo. That was much more lethal because there were chokes in that would take people out.
Lethal for you. You could probably die trying to do it.
No, I mean, judo is
judo.
It's been a long time.
Why even bring it up then?
No, I'm just saying because it's much more.
But you know the show. We have a big square footage here.
Oh yeah.
You know, if you bring up that you used to judo, obviously we're gonna ask you to do it. So don't bring it up.
Okay, sorry, buddy.
Is judo's the holds, right? Isn't that
like arm bars and throws and like there's a lot of lethal shots.
Like you want to get them to the mat. In judo, I think you want to get them to the mat.
Yeah, but you know,
right?
Probably
I'm thinking if he tries to hold me in any way, I'm out of the fight. It's fine. Yeah. You win. You're judo
he
champion.
Tries to hold you.
No, but the most lethal martial art is probably Krav Maga.
What's that?
Who's he?
Is that the Batman one?
Krav Maga. Krav Maga's a drunk who used to drink down at the Malkahi's on the 27th.
He's at the Port Authority now.
Jack Pesci can tell you about it. It's like a
Krav Maga. Who can tell you about it?
Pesci.
Jack Pesci, that lethal force.
Mm-hmm. No.
Kid who went to private schools in the private high school in Manhattan, Jack Pesson. What did he do? This kid Jack works for us.
It's like it was developed by an Israeli soldier. It's no joke.
The Israeli soldier, I'm sure, is great at it. But I got a feeling Jack Pesson.
You got to watch it online. It's no joke.
But let's get, you know, it's not all about you. Let's get the Julian's
question. Okay, I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah, sure. I'm fine with this line of questioning, by the way.
I'm sorry.
I want to see Mike do judo so bad.
This is like, you know, it's like a comic coming on Letterman, and all of a sudden you're hearing about Paul Schaefer's karate career.
That's true, which I would also be fine with.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
Hi-ya. It's a thing I'm doing for the kids.
What, nice Paul Schaefer, Dan. Very nice. So what's going on, man?
I just came from a show in New Jersey.
You did a set?
It was okay.
Where'd you play?
The Stress Factory in New Jersey.
Oh,
where I started. It's my home club. I went to Rutgers and it went all right. It's, you know, I moved.
See Vinny Brand, my buddy.
And he's great. We were messing with the feature. He said he was going to cancel him because he didn't have any TV credits right before the show. It was great.
Vinny's a great guy. Vinny, the owner of the Stress Factory, also a good comic in his own right.
Yeah,
really
absolutely.
Good.
Yeah. And I learned everything I know about manipulating people from that guy. So it's
you need that in show business.
You do. Yeah, it was a good lesson.
Especially comedy.
Yeah.
The great thing about the Stress Factory is they would always have a big buffet out.
Yeah.
That the comedians and the audience could eat before the show started.
Yeah, it was funny because I remember when I was there anyway, it was $3 a person. and if anybody that wasn't supposed to eat it was eating it, he'd get furious. And it was $3 a person. And he would yell, I mean, you know, the guy's
scream.
He's got a boat and he's mad about somebody eating some manicotti out of the thing.
Yellow rice. That was big there.
But Mike went and we had a ravioli one time. He thought he was getting laid afterwards.
Mike, you played the Stress Factory.
Yeah, you've been there, Mike, right?
That's a nice room. It's one of the best.
It is.
I love that room.
Oh, no, it's true.
It's great.
It's Central Jersey's premier club.
Yeah,
great
absolutely.
Room for comedy.
Yeah, and I learned there, and it's like, it can be pretty chaotic in there. It's pretty, you know, it's like for my first show I ever did on, ever. Like I never did an open mic or anything like that. Vinny threw me on a sold out Friday night.
Oh my God.
And I had no material. I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't know how to hold a microphone. Oh, I don't remember, but I think it was actually, I think it might've been Thea Vidal.
Okay.
Yeah. And
her crowd kind of loud, I'm assuming.
Yeah. Yeah. But it was just packed. And I remember the feeling in the room was definitely like, the crowd was like, why are they making this poor person do this? Like, it wasn't like they thought I wanted to be up there.
It was a disaster. A sold-out Thea Vidal crowd, that's like waterboarding.
Yeah, exactly.
That's terrible.
And I remember I went home that night because it was the first time I realized I might not be funny at all. And I drank a bottle of vodka in my roommate's bed because I didn't want to sleep in my own bed and passed out. So that was my first comedy experience. And then now I headline the place.
Good for you, man.
So that's cool.
So you did a Valentine's night show.
Yeah, Valentine's night. You know,
always weird in comedy to Valentine's.
It is. Yeah, they're a little. You know, all the guys think they're on their best behavior and stuff like that, so they don't want to laugh at anything.
I emceed. I emceed once at Stand Up New York. This had to be like 15 years ago for Valentine's Day, and
was the Miami Herald there?
No, they had since abandoned me. It was one of those things where, like, you know, for an extra $15. The owner would get the MC to give flowers or balloons to a woman from stage from a guy. So I had to give a bunch of Mylar balloons to a woman.
By the way, that's not enough money. Everybody's going to ask for that, and then you got to do it all night long.
Right, no, but a bunch of people and I just wasn't into it. My heart was not into giving this woman Mylar balloons. And I sat there. I walk up with Mylar balloons. Okay, I look like Willy Wonka. And I go, is Valerie here? And she's like, yeah. And I'm like, here. And the guy wanted his money back because he said that the MC was not into it. I wasn't into it. But that's good. So now,
what grown man gets upset when another grown man doesn't want to give balloons
to his girlfriend? Let him do it. I would have rather brought him up and let him do it.
I know.
Here, Val, what am I supposed to think? Something nice to say?
We've done engagements. I remember having to do that all the time at the Stress Factory.
I've never done
people in
done
New Jersey
that.
Think it's so, it's like fine to ask your girlfriend to marry you in front of a Saturday Night Late show.
Yeah, because they're sympathetic.
Like, some girl is going to think that's so romantic. Right. You know what I mean?
Especially Central Jersey, you're not going to get it. It's everyone on Twitter who's a scumbag.
Yeah.
But in person.
I know, exactly. That's what... That's,
yelling out.
And but it always, believe it or not, like, whenever the guy got on his knee, like, on stage, the whole crowd just lost it. I mean, who it really sucks for is the next guy that has to go on and perform. How are you going to follow an engagement?
You can't.
Because it's honest and, like, real. And then a comic's going to go and be like, hey, well, how you doing? Where are you from?
Yeah, yeah.
You
know? You'd rather follow a rape. stick around. We got a break. Again, the Dan break symbol is the most annoying thing. I've been in show business for 20 years. The most annoying thing I've ever seen is Dan Filato giving me the break thing.
Yeah.
Single most annoying thing I've ever seen.